So how does Christianity explain free will, right? Because how could God be omniscient and we have free will in the same time? That's something I couldn't understand for a while.
Yeah, it is a paradox. It's strange. I mean, I can't say I have the perfect answer. The only thing I can say is in an internal realm, God sees everything. And in the finite realm, we don't see everything. And so therefore, in our mind, we have a choice. But in God's mind, it's already done. So
does that mean, like, for example, you believe in the God is already preset since he created the universe?
Well, I mean,
that would be kind of unfair, right?
It would be unfair. And so that's why it's a mystery, because in some way,
because you're lucky that God set you to believe. And say, you know, my great grandparents who never had access to Jesus Christ, like, you know.
Well, this is my theory. My theory is that although we can see the end, God can see the end, because he made us in his image, we have the ability to create and to change things. And based on that divine nature living within us. And so, because of that, there is an actual free will. However, because God knows, because he's eternal, people's decisions, like a mathematical equation, in that way he knows what we will do. And so that's, I guess, it's still the paradox.
Yeah.
You know,
I've been trying to find religion for a while now, and this just perplexes me. Like, it's stopping me from actually committing to something.
Let's just say God didn't know what the future was.
Thank you.
You still have a choice, and the choices that you make will lead you to a destination, whether you like it or not. Now, if God knew everything, in our mind, we still have a choice. And you don't know that you don't. As far as you're concerned, you have a choice right now. Everybody, if I talk with somebody, they have a choice to talk to me or not.
Exactly.
So what I'm saying is, in our mind, we have a choice.
Yeah.
But in God, God sees the choices we're going to make.
Okay, so in God's reality,
he sees the choices.
Have a choice.
Well, because eternity, if you're living in an eternal realm, you see the end from the beginning.
Uh-huh.
We don't.
Yeah.
So the reason why God can see where we're going to go is not that he's dictating. Uh-huh. It's just that he sees it all in a picture.
I see. Okay.
So that's how I understand it.
That's an interesting interpretation. I've never thought of it.
So if you're in an eternal realm, you see finite easily. When you're in a finite realm, you can't see eternity. So the moment we die, like, we're now in a totally different realm.
Uh-huh. Gotcha.
So it's not necessarily that God dictated it. It's just God created us, and he sees the end.
That's interesting.
Yeah.
I'm not fully convinced, but that is very interesting.
Best one I got.
Yeah. I'm trying to figure it out, man.
Yeah, man. Well, at the end of the day, bro, every choice you make leads to a conclusion, and there is the best conclusion that we can all accept or at least acknowledge is that there is a creator. Everything has a designer behind it. So regardless of which way we spin it, there's still something that brought everything into being.
Oh, by the way, another question is that, say, if my great-great-great-great-grandparents who never had access to Jesus Christ, who never knew this existed, right? Because they were in, I don't know, remote corner of China, that was not a thing by the time. Does that mean they just go to hell straight away?
Or? No, I think that they have a seed of truth that if they embraced it, they would have trusted in the Messiah if he were to come. So whatever they knew was pointing to the Messiah. So even people in the Old Testament, Jesus didn't die yet, but they had simple sacrifices that pointed to the sacrifice of Christ. So if they believed in that, that was a sign that I was humble. My sin is so serious that it needed a death penalty. So if your ancestors realized that they were sinful, and the knowledge that they had there said, you know what, you need to be humble for your sins. There needs to be a recompense for their error. There needs to be something to replace what you did. And they were humble enough to do that.
Yeah.
That was as if they were believing in Jesus.
Oh, so even though they do not know.
That was a symbol and a sign of Jesus. Yes.
So does that mean, like, say, some Muslim who grew up in from ages ago who did not know?
If they did not know,
who are indoctrinated?
Yeah, because the principle is the same, no matter which way you spin it. Even your
the time environment just keeps you from actually changing, right? Wouldn't it be unfair for people who never be able to talk to you never be able to see an actual Christian who are in a household that just completely Muslim, never left the household?
It's true.
Left the city,
it's true. You know? But here's the thing. When we're seeking the truth, the Bible says you're going to find it, just like you. You're seeking the truth, and the little knowledge that you have, you're getting the answers. So if you're really sincere and you really want to be with God, you'd be asking questions. You'd be a Muslim, like, how can I know the truth? Why does it talk about a Bible? I want to know what this Bible says.
Interesting.
And it would lead you to the truth.
Interesting. Appreciate it, man.
Hey, God bless you, brother.
All right, thanks.
Amen.